Joining me now, Senator Saxby Chambliss of Georgia. He's the ranking Republican on the Senate Intelligence Committee. Senator, thanks for coming on today. First, I want to get your reaction to these new airstrikes, apparently going after ISIS oil targets, refineries, possibly oil fields as well.
Well, these targets have been identified over the last several weeks. We've been flying ISR, trying to pick out
targets. Surveillance. That ISR is surveillance.
Yes. Targets that would cause the least amount of collateral damage, but yet seek to really do damage to the infrastructure of ISIL. And in all probability, the attacks at the Pentagon is now confirming were against these portable refineries or these movable refineries that are small in nature, but they're pretty significant. And again, it's smart to attack them in their pocketbook where they have been very successful thus far. So I suspect that's probably what the Pentagon will ultimately confirm, and I think that's the right thing to do.
Senator, what, in addition to the money that ISIS has been able to bring in, reportedly $2 million a day from controlling these oil fields, also several millions from ransoms and kidnappings, what are the other reasons why the world is so terrified, why leaders are so concerned about ISIS? What makes them different from any other terrorist group?
Well, they're an offshoot of al-Qaeda, but frankly, they were the leader, Baghdadi, was actually kicked out of al-Qaeda because he was too extreme for the leadership in al-Qaeda. So we've seen the viciousness of the group. We've seen the way, this friend talked earlier, the way they try to intimidate individuals, groups, as well as leadership of countries. And they will continue to do that if we don't react in the right way. ISIL is, they're a terrorist group, just like al-Qaeda, al-Shabaab, and Boko Haram, all of these other groups that are being talked about. But the fact is, they operate under a different MO than any of those groups. And that MO is, we're gonna be the nastiest guys around and don't get in our way. That's why I think it's important that we take them head on. We hit their infrastructure, we hit their logistics centers, we hit their depots. Those are the types of structures that have been hit over the last couple of days and the kinds that I know have been identified over the last few weeks that we're gonna continue to go after.
Senator, stay with us for 1 second. I'm told Barbara Starr at the Pentagon has some new information, and I just want to go to her. Barbara, what can you tell us?
Well, Jake, we're just getting a few more details here. What we're looking at is U.S. and coalition aircraft, including aircraft from the United Arab Emirates, hitting about a dozen targets in eastern Syria in a very remote area. We're told they are these remote targets, these oil refineries, if you will, are east and south of Raqqa. Raqqa, of course, being basically the stronghold of the ISIS leadership. These are small modular refineries, we're told, way out in the desert, not near civilian populations. The calculation that we talked about a minute ago, that ISIS is earning itself about $2 million a day from this illegal and criminal oil smuggling operation, they're refining, we're told, about 300 to 500 barrels a day. Relatively speaking, in the oil market, that is a very small amount, of course. It doesn't impact oil prices on the market as you and I would know it around the world, but it is impacting the oil business in that area. And a lot of people out there have been very, very upset about ISIS, aside from their criminal enterprise, their terrorism activity, their economic activity. Basically, this is money stolen from legitimate oil business in the region. So again, what we're getting to is the U.S. and the coalition, the Arab nations, many of them oil producers, oil refiners in their own rights, now really prosecuting the campaign against ISIS economic targets, against their oil business. This is really the next step. The U.S. knew about these targets. I want to point that out. They didn't get to them in that very first round. It's not like they just discovered them, we're told. This was known to be out there, and this is a set of targets that the U.S. and the coalition wanted to get to. They couldn't get to everything on the first night, but they've gotten to it now.
Joining us on the phone right now is Lieutenant General Mark Hertling, a CNN military analyst. General, tell us what you think the significance is of the coalition going after these apparently portable oil refineries that ISIS has been using as part of their influx of millions of dollars.
Yeah, Jake, a couple of things. First, I'll compliment both Barbara and Colonel Francona for their comments because they are right on target. When I was in northern Iraq, it was also an area of emphasis for us because Al-Qaeda at the time was stealing oil from the Beji refinery and really co-opting and intimidating the truck drivers and using the stolen oil to fund their operations. When you're talking about a group like ISIS in Syria having their own refineries, you would see that this is certainly part of a strategic offensive air campaign. You not only have to stop this money flow, which is significant, as Barbara just pointed out, but it's also them attempting to establish part of their infrastructure of a state. So that's really the objective of ISIS, is to establish their own state in the areas of Syria and Iraq. And anytime you can hit the infrastructure that prevents them from doing that, it's a good thing. So the economy piece of this is a significant part, and they're using that money not only to fund their operations, but to pay their fighters and to pay the jihadis as they arrive in various, in Turkey and in Syria and in places they're coming into. So this is part of the overall campaign, the strategic objectives of stopping the economy of this state.
I want to bring back Senator Saxby Chambliss, ranking Republican on the Senate Intelligence Committee. Senator, one thing that I'm wondering as we're sitting here and we're watching these strikes against some of the oil targets that are controlled by ISIS, but certainly there are many more. How long do you think this war is going to go on? You have access to top secret, to classified information. You have an idea of how strong ISIS truly is. Do you think that we're going to be covering these airstrikes like this, in months, in years? How long?
Well, airstrikes can do a significant amount of damage. We're all very aware of that. But airstrikes are not going to win this conflict. Ultimately, they're going to have to be boots on the ground. And if you notice, the president danced around that very carefully today. He said from the beginning that there will be no U.S. boots on the ground. But the fact of the matter is, we've got about 1,700 boots on the ground in Iraq right now in an advisory capacity. But the one thing he didn't say is, who's going to provide those boots? And that's, frankly, I think, the next step. I'm very confident that the administration is having success in talking to our Arab friends that have joined this flight. I think it's pretty amazing that the administration has been able to get the coalition they have of the Arab neighbors to join us. From the standpoint of the airstrikes. Now the next move is we've got to have those Arab neighbors join in by providing boots on the ground to root these folks out. And who knows, Jake? I mean, this thing could last months and months. Conceivably, it could last years. But this is not going to be an easy fight.
Senator Saxby Chambliss of Georgia, thank you so much. Let's bring back former Obama White House Press Secretary Jay Carney and Weekly Standard editor